Hi. Over a year ago, I shared a video showing the design of my robot for last year's Danish RoboCup competition. Since then, I made a few changes to the robot's gripper. It's now a bit simpler because this year's competition only required the robot to pick up one ball. It worked well in my workshop, but let's see how it performed in the actual competition. Here's the robot at the starting point. In the top right, you can see the view from the robot's camera, and the camera is used for most of the navigation on the track. The blue box shows where the line is detected. Most of the time, the robot aims for the center of this box, but at branches, it uses the left or the right edge to choose the correct direction. The orange box is where it looks for a ball to pick up, and as you will see in a moment, the green box at the top is where it checks to see if the track is blocked at the X obstacle. But let's get the robot started. According to the rules, the robot gets 1 point each time it passes a yellow gate. After the first gate, it heads straight for the X. It checks in the top of the image to see if the path is clear, and then continues. Next is a pre-programmed section to get back to the line where it doesn't use the camera. Instead, it's just using the wheel encoders to know how far it has driven. At this point, it switches between following the left and the right edge of the line to avoid getting confused by the branches. The line detection algorithm is looking for the line in the entire bottom row of the image. It uses a dynamic threshold based on the overall brightness, and it assumes brighter pixels are the line. This works well. Well, most of the time, but it does fail occasionally, as you will see later. Right before the ramp, the robot slows down to detect the incline change. That tells it exactly where the ramp starts, so that it can follow the line at a fixed distance before turning at the branch. So yeah, it doesn't actually detect the branch, it just knows where it is. At the seesaw, it starts looking for the ball. This time, the ball was already centered in the view, so the robot could just pick it up without turning. Then it again looks for the incline change to detect when it has left the seesaw. That triggers a pre-programmed path back to the line on the second ramp. Here you'll notice that the robot starts to wiggle a bit. That's because the line detection algorithm sees the sunspots and mistakes them for the line. During testing, I didn't run the robot at this time of the day, so I wasn't prepared for the sunlight. It could have resulted in a spectacular fail with the robot driving over the edge. But luckily, it stayed on the line, so it could put the ball in the hole. Next, it goes for the second ball. This time, the ball isn't centered, so the robot turns to align with it. To drop the ball in the hole, it follows the line back to the ramp. It once again detects the incline to know where the ramp ends, and from there it runs another pre-programmed path to align with the hole and drop the ball. I often use fixed points that are not based on the camera data, as they're less likely to be affected by external changes like the sunlight. The downside is that the robot has to drive slower to make sure it's following exactly the same path each time. So yeah, it doesn't use the camera to detect the hole, it just knows where it is based on the ramp's edge. Now all that's left is to go down the ramp and head for the goal. On the wooden surface, the line detection sometimes failed, but instead of fixing it, I just made the robot follow a defined path. Yeah, simple, but it got the job done. In total, the robot got 12 points on the track, and then it got an extra point for stability, because I told the judges how many points it would go for before the run, and it got exactly that. I hope you enjoyed this short video of the robot in action. If you would like to see how the other robots did, I will link the competition video below. Thanks for watching.